Hey guys, Sid here with another Minecraft video. Today we have some more of the charcoal factory stuff. Figured why not just make it into a smelting factory. Yeah, here's 3 failed attempts by me. Right here, this is the last one that I worked on. I had a lot of trouble with it, and my friend got concerned and got on Minecraft and tried to make one too, but he couldn't do it either. But I was able to finally make one. The problem with this design is that you need a filtration system, and the only way to do that is to have these hoppers powered, and that won't work because you need to have the items go into it. And, found a way to do that with the dispensers, but that also requires a filtration system, which is leading into a circular logic. But yeah, here's the newest one, the one that works. Let me just give you a quick demo here. Grab some iron, some gold, some wood, some planks, and yeah. So we put in our fuel. Okay. And then we wait for it to be smelted. Usually, if you're going to be making this, you'll be away from the device. But yeah. The way this is working is instantly getting sucked up by the hopper. And then uses a quick pulse from the dropper to shoot it up to these other hoppers, and then I have another quick pulse set up to where it affects 2 droppers, and it goes into this hopper and into the chest. Now then, we don't have to just sit there and do wood. We can do all the other stuff. It is automated, so it should automatically go in whenever the wood's done. Yeah. And soon we should have some iron and some gold. Shut up, Steve! That actually went into the furnace.
What?
Into the top part. So yeah, there you can see we got the charcoal, the gold, and the iron. No, I'm not. I don't need to hide my derps. My little derpy moments. I've been on this damn thing for 5 hours. I should be allowed to mess up once in a while. This is fairly simple to make. It's definitely more compact than the tennis ACs and Cube Masters, I think that was his name, the one that they work on. And it's more useful because you don't have to limit it to just charcoal. Alright guys, so here's a tutorial for this. It might lag, I don't know. But yeah, I'm gonna need both chests for this. Yeah. At least one down and then the other. And then away from that, do another chest. I'll just leave that there for now. Except for that. Put your hoppers on the bottom. Use your furnace. You can put this any way. It doesn't really matter. Put another hopper down. And underneath of that. But we've actually got to do that. Put a dispenser down. Now we've got to power that. Wait, which way is this facing? Is it up? Put your dispenser down facing up, and then you can power it. Simply like that. And then we've got our little line of hoppers that lead to a couple droppers. I'm not sure if I called that a dispenser earlier. It's a dropper. I'm always getting those two mixed up. Now we're just going to do the same powering as before, except like that and that. Put a redstone here and also there. This will make it pulse when right after this pulses. And then that means this will push the item up. Now we need our hopper there. And that looks like it's it. So yeah, I grabbed something to give a quick test. Don't drop it like a derp, like I did. When that chest is open, the hopper is deactivated. That's why it wasn't working before. And you've seen it in action. There it goes. Yeah. So, yeah, I hope you find this helpful. If you would like to work on a redstone contraption together, you know, send me a message or write a comment. I would recommend doing a video response so I can actually see what you're trying to do. I can usually troubleshoot some redstone problems easily, but sometimes it's just hard for me to wrap my brain around it. So yeah, once you have the contraption done and working, you can just put up your walls and your signs. And I don't know if some of you don't know, but to place stuff on other stuff that has like GUIs, you just hold shift and right click. That's it.